Me bringing it, but because, for I'm only the man. never individual in here that leaves nobody out. It's for myself and everybody. It's for all mankind, where no matter where you're at in your life's journey, this message is for each and every soul.
Yes.
Now, most of my messages, the Lord has me to bring them out as more in the manner of teaching, not this message. For he has instructed me to preach this message this morning. Bring out the preacher in me.
Yes.
So if y'all will allow me to turn loose,
yes,
break free, get real with you,
pray the Lord.
Yes.
So if y'all will, let's go ahead and go into the reading. But before I even get started, I want to make it clear. This altar is always open.
Yes, always.
Don't think you're going to be interrupting the service to come up here and kneel in at the altar. It don't matter if I'm up here preaching or what's going on. There's plenty of others in here to pray with you. If the Lord instructs for the whole congregation to come to the altar, that's fine too. This building is surrounded by angels. We'll be but I know without a shadow of a doubt, this message is going to pierce some hearts in here this morning. If it pierces your heart, stirs your spirit, go ahead and let your spirit flow into God's presence and do what he is telling you to do. For at the moment he is drawing, that is the time to take action.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Starting at the 11th verse. Ephesians 4. And he gave some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, that we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness whereby they lie and wait to deceive, but speaking the truth in love may grow up into him in all things, which is the head, even Christ, for whom the whole body fitly joined together and compacted by that which every joint supplieth, according to the effectual working in the measure of every part, maketh increase the body unto the edifying of itself in love.
Amen.
Now this message this morning, the Lord has instructed me to preach it in four different sections. Some of you will be able, as myself, be able to characterize yourself in more than one section. Now I've entitled this message, Preparing for the Harvest. In order for us to prepare for the harvest, usually comes revival. We can't think of revival without first thinking of lost souls.
That's right.
So that's the first section that I'm going to be preaching on this morning. Is any of you in here that has not yet completely turned your life over to God and you trusted him with your life and accepted the Lord Jesus Christ into your life as your Lord and Savior,
yes,
I urge you to do so immediately.
Yes.
Do it this morning.
Yes. Yes.
Now, I know what you're thinking, for I know how Satan, I've been there myself. You just think, well, preacher, I would love to, but I really don't know a whole lot about this Christian life you're talking about. Or I don't know and understand a lot about salvation. That's just the devil talking.
Yeah.
That's the way the devil gets through to us. So he starts to deceive us through our wrong thinkings and think they ain't right. He gets to us through our minds. Well, a lot of times we can understand things more in the carnal than in the spirit. So I'm bringing it out like this. Those of you that is married will understand exactly what I'm talking about. Before we married our spouses, we dated our spouses. I hope anyway. It don't matter if it was one day or 5 years. But the longer you dated your spouse, the more you got to know about that spouse. But you didn't really know them. You did not know of their full capabilities until you gave that real relationship with them and you was committed to them. Then you really learned who they was, what they was, and their capabilities.
That's right.
You knew they could get on your nerves, but you didn't know how much they could get on your nerves until you gave that real relationship with them. The same way with God. We know of His love. We know of His blessings. We know it feels great when the Spirit gets on us with the cold chills and weeping.
Yes.
But we really don't know how great His love is till He gets in us.
Yes.
We don't know how to know and understand how great His grace is till we got that real relationship with Him. And we sure don't know how great He feels when we receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Those cold chills is nothing like when He gets on the inside of us. I'll go ahead and put it out there. I've been high on drugs. I've been high on alcohol. But there's no high like the high I get when I'm in the presence of God. Yeah. If you're here, you don't have not accepted the Lord Jesus Christ. Go ahead and repent by acknowledging your wrongdoings as sins, asking for your forgiveness. His forgiveness.
Yes.
Ask Him to come and live in your life.
Amen.
Amen.
For it's when usually a lost soul comes to God that starts a revival.
Yeah.
Because it starts to spark sparks in some of the Christians that have gotten a little cold in their relationship with God.
Yeah.
That's the second section of the messages. Why is it a lot of times we as Christians, we have lost our fire? For Jesus baptized us with the Holy Ghost and with fire. Their fire is their zeal to live for Him, do as He says, and walk after Him. But a lot of times we lose that fire. Why? There's several reasons. But usually the first one is sin. For sin, it affects our Christian walk.
That's
it
right.
Affects our relationship with God.
That's right.
We start to get less and less in our prayer times because it may just start out with a little thing. But
yeah.
It's like a disease. It just keeps getting worse to where we grow completely cold. Now, if we have sin, we need to go ahead and resolve it and get back on track with God.
That's right.
Now that we've got this sin issue over with, let's look at other things that causes us as Christians to grow cold in the Lord. Which growing cold in the Lord is a very dangerous state to be. For in Revelations, Jesus tells us, I'd rather you be cold or hot, for if you're lukewarm, I will spit you out of my mouth. A lot of times we don't understand this. Why would He rather us as Christians be cold than lukewarm? Now the hot, we can understand that. I mean, that's self-explanatory. But why would He rather us be cold than lukewarm? Because lukewarm is closer to being hot than cold is. He's getting the revelation. The way He's gave it to me, I'll bring it out. First of all, let's go ahead and talk about the cold. When we're cold in the Lord, we grow cold, we're missing that relationship with Him. And anybody that's been in this for any time at all, I do not know a Christian that has not gotten cold. But we get cold, we get uncomfortable, It don't matter how much fun we're having, it's still something missing.
That's right.
And we can't wait to do what we got to do to get back to our relationship with God so we can feel Him again. Now, lukewarm. And this is why I feel that God really despises a lukewarm relationship of His children. When we're lukewarm, it says, Luke, I think it's the second chapter around the 40, about the 41st verse, it tells us that Joseph and Mary, when they went to Passover, when they was leaving Passover, they left Jesus. They didn't even realize it at first. A day later, after a day's journey, they got to missing Jesus, realized He wasn't with them, for they thought He was there all along in the crowd. But when they realized they had left Jesus, they turned back to go seek Him. That's the way we are as Christians. We start to lose more and more time with God. We get spending less and less time in our prayer time. We don't meditate on Him as much. Before long, we're leaving Jesus.
Oh, wow.
Only time we can find Jesus when we come to the one service on Sunday morning, and then we wind up leaving Him at the church. Because we think He's out there in the crowd, we think He's somewhere in our everyday lives, not realizing we've done left Jesus. But if we continue in this situation, it won't be long. We'll only be coming to church and not even picking Jesus up at all. We'll only be going through the motions. But we need to make sure we don't leave Jesus. And if we have, we need to turn back and go seek Him.
Yes. Amen.
Now, I'm going to speak on the church. Not you and man, but we, the church, the whole body of Christ. Now, when you see ministers and ministries start to pull together and work together, then that's when we know we're in for a great harvest.
Yes.
For God is pulling His people together. It don't matter. You may go to a different church. May go to a different denominational name. As long as you believe in God the Creator, the Father of all,
believe in
Jesus Christ, believe He is the one that died on the cross for our sins, and believe it's only through Him that we receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, then we're all on the same page. We need to identify our enemy.
Yes. Yeah.
We're not. Other Christians is not our enemy.
That's right.
No matter what their denominational name is or what church they go to,
we're
on the same team.
That's right.
But it's time that we as the Christian bodies start to pull together now to identify Satan as our enemy instead of each other to start working together.
Yes.
For God is bringing His people together to put His church in unity for the great and final harvest.
That's right.
And it's time for we as the church to bring back our families and get our churches back.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes. Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Now, you and me, our church body, part of the church body, we can see that we're an on-fire church. We can see that we're a blessed church.
Yes.
We want to remain that way.
Yes.
We do this because we know God is in control.
That's right.
We may schedule our meetings, but they flow the way God wants them.
Yes.
If He's going to come in here and interrupt, we let Him interrupt.
Right. Absolutely.
We let God be God.
Yes.
We get self out of the way. These services, it's not about me. They're not about Sister Martha. They're not about Brother Joey. They're not nothing about all of us. First of all, they're to glorify God.
Absolutely.
They're about each and every one of us together.
Amen.
giving each other encouragement, support, uplifting, to help each other in our Christian walk with God.
Thank you, Lord.